Namaste children, welcome to our next class. In last class you learned about effects of force, what force can do and how it helps to stop a moving object, how a force can move a stationary object and how force is helping to change the shape of an object. This all you learnt in before class. And in today's class we are going to learn about the different types of forces, how the force is different from each object and how many different types of forces we are using in our day-to-day life, we'll see now. The first one is magnetic force. This you can enjoy a lot by doing this activity. How a magnetic force affects on any object, you will do a small experiment and then you can enjoy and feel the force of magnets. So for doing this activity, you need a small magnet and iron fillings you take and just bring the magnet near to the iron fillings. How the iron fillings are getting attracted towards magnet, you can see and you feel the force of magnet, how it is created. So the magnet attracts the iron nails because the magnet has a force that attracts the iron nails. Magnetic field, we will say, up the area up to where the magnet is showing its magnetic effect, that's known as magnetic field. The force applied by a magnet on an object is called magnetic force or magnetism. So this type of force which is exhibited by the magnets called as magnetic force. Applied by a magnet on a metal object is called as magnetic force or magnetism. So this is one type of force we are using to make our machines to work and to different day-to-day things or machineries to work, we are using magnetic force. And the other type of force is electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force, to understand this, here also you can do one small activity. You just comb your hair many times with a comb and make it ready some bits of papers. Some papers you make into small pieces, and after combing many a times, you bring that comb near to the bits of papers. And it will be wondering, these papers will stick to the comb. This is because the force created by the electrostatic force, the force created by rubbing many a times, the comb is exhibiting some force which is called as electrostatic force. Because of that, the comb is attracting the bits of papers. When you comb your hair, your dry hair, and bring the comb near to tiny bits of papers, the papers gets attracted towards the comb. This activity, practically you do it and enjoy this activity, children. This is because on rubbing, the comb gets charged and attracts the tiny bits of papers. So when things are rubbed each other, they become charged and a force is produced between them, and this force is only known as electrostatic force. So how the comb is attracting the bits of papers, you can see, and just do a small pocket comb, rub many times to your head and take near to the bits of papers. So tiny bits of papers, you keep it ready beforehand. And just as soon as rubbing stopped, then you take the comb near to the papers and observe how the energy or the force produced between the comb and the tiny bits of papers you can see. And another type of force, this is because of this force we are able to live on planet Earth. Just anything, when you try to throw it up, you can observe that as soon as you throw it up and immediately it's coming and falling on the ground. This is because the earth is showing some force that's called as gravitational force. Everything that you throw up in the air, again definitely it will come down. ripened fruits always fall on the ground from a tree. You might have seen, and this is also found by a scientist, and he also observed that how an apple is falling from a tree, and he found many laws based on this. This gravitational laws, Newton laws, you're going to learn in higher classes. So what is the reason why the apple, ripened apple, is always falling down? You can understand by the force which is exhibited by the ground or the earth, that is only known as gravitational force. You cannot jump beyond a certain height. Do you know why? Our earth exerts a force. When you jump so high, even though again you will come and fall on the land. This is because of the force which is exhibited by the earth that attracts the objects towards the center of its surface, and this force is only known as gravity or the gravitational force. And now you can see the another force which is called as buoyant force. So when you push down an object, example a ball in water, you feel an upward push. This upward push resists the ball from going down. The upward force acting on an object in the water is called as buoyant force. Because of this force only, the ship is able to float on the water. And even the lotus flower, the lotus flower, the lotus leaves are floating on the water due to the buoyant force, because the upward force acting on an object in the water, when any object in the water, so some upward pressure is acting on them. So this upward force acting on these objects when they are in the water, that's only known as buoyant force. Okay. So till now you learned the different types of frictions forces. Those are magnetic force, electrostatic force, gravitational force, buoyant force. So the four different types of force which we apply on different objects depending on the convenient, depending on the work what you are doing. So based on this only, different types of machineries and day-to-day life objects are prepared. And force is also creating some friction. Then we'll see what's the meaning of a friction. When you roll a ball over a floor, it gradually slows down and finally stops. This you are in many a times you are playing this in your day-to-day life. Just roll a ball on the ground, it moves slowly and then finally it stops moving. In the same way, when you stop paddling your cycle, it gradually slows down and stops. Why do they stop like this? When you roll a ball, when you throw a ball on the ground, it's moving faster and after some time it's becoming slow and stopping the movement. In the same way, when you are pedaling a bicycle, it moves faster and then it becomes slow, finally it stops. This is because they stop because a force acts between the ball and the floor that slows down the ball. This force only known as frictional force or force of friction. So this is occurring, the friction is occurring between two objects when they come in contact with each other. Thus a force that slows down the movement of objects on a surface is called force of friction. So it is also called force of resistance. So these are the, you can see here in the picture, pushing the force, and it is when it is in the movement, then slowly a force is formed between two objects, and then the moving object becomes slow and it gets stopped. So what are the advantages of friction? Is it helping us always to stop the moving objects? No, not at all. It's also helping us to walk. We cannot walk easily on a very smooth surface or a wet floor. because there is very less friction and we may slip over the floor. So when two surfaces are very smooth, then the friction is less. Very less friction. Between two smooth surfaces, friction is so less. So friction, where the friction is so less, there is a chance to slip over or to fall. And friction between road and the tires of automobiles make their movement possible. So any movement is occurring when one object surface is very rough and the other object surface is smooth, then the movement can occur easily. So the vehicles are moving on the road due to the friction between the road and the tires. So the road is smooth and the tires have some grooves in between and they have rough surface. So smooth and rough surface coming in contact and forming the friction. And you are able to write with your pen because of friction. You often see that you cannot write easily on an oily paper. This is because the oily paper is very smooth. At the same time, the tip of your pen is also very smooth. So when two smooth surfaces come in contact, friction is not formed at all. So you cannot write on that paper. So instead of that, to avoid, you have to take a rough paper without any oily or without smooth surface, then you can write easily because one is smooth surface and the tip of the pen is smooth surface and the paper is rough surface, so that you can write on that paper easily. So friction also helps to erase pencil marks from the paper by using an eraser. This is the very known example for you. When you write something wrong, you'll be erasing with the eraser, and the letters which you have written, you are able to erase because the friction which is occurring between the smooth surface of the eraser and the paper, so that you are able to erase the letters which you wrote on paper. And at the same time, some disadvantages are also there with this frictional force. Then what are those disadvantages? It slows down or stops the motion of vehicles. Just now we had seen the rolling ball. When you roll the ball on the ground, how it's getting stopped, we understood by doing the activity. So these all activities, when you do, you'll understand nicely what's the meaning of friction and the different forces. So it's helping, it is slowing down the moving vehicles. The motion of the vehicles gets stopped by the friction. And the friction produces heat that damages the machines. That is why we use oil and sieving machine, cycle, etc. So whenever the friction is formed, and from so many days when we are using these machineries, and the heat is produced when two objects coming in contact, and a force, if the frictional force is formed between them, and some heat is produced between these two objects, and so that the machinery may get spoiled. So to avoid this only, oiling is done in sewing machines and the cycles. And friction also damages the tires of vehicles and soles of your shoes. You are able to walk on the ground because of the shoe sole. It has the sole, between the sole and the ground, a force is formed called as frictional force. Due to the friction, the heat is produced and your sole of your shoes may get spoiled after some days. So there are very little disadvantages, but in a lot many ways the friction is also helping us. So whenever two smooth surfaces are there the friction is very less. So very less means there is a chance of falling or disadvantage it may be. So whenever one smooth surface, one rough surface are there, then the friction works out well. So that we use for walking or to work many machineries and all. And one more activity which is given in your textbook, page number 92. Do this activity and write your observations in the A4 sheet clearly. So once we'll go through that activity, which is given in page 92. So this aim of this activity is to observe the friction on different types of surfaces. So here you need a box, a smooth and rough surfaces. So what you are doing, the procedure is you push a heavy object on a rough surface, then push the same object on a smooth surface. In which case do you apply great force? We need to apply a great force to move an object on a rough surface. So conclusion is friction is more on a rough surface as compared to the smooth surface. So write this activity on A4 sheet and also complete the MCQs which are given in page 92 based on the different forces. So these are the two areas you have to work, and send me your pics, children. Thank you.